So, hello everyone. 10 minutes about the essentials and fundamentals of extracorporeal shockwave science. My name is Christoph Schmitz. I'm an MD, PhD, full professor, head of a big basic science department at the University of Munich in Germany. I'm consulting for electromedical systems, and here you see a little bit about my publications in the field if you'd like to know more about what I'm actually doing. Shockwaves are characterized as pressure as a function of time, single acoustic pulses with a certain peak positive pressure, certain peak negative pressure, and the area under the curve is actually the energy density. In this publication, we put a lot of the theory together. You see here in B and C measured focused shockwaves from devices that are available, and in D, this is the pressure versus function of time of the dollar class radial shockwaves. To make a very, very long story very short, the key difference between focused shockwaves and radial shockwaves is not the physics of the shockwave itself. They differ quantitatively, but not qualitatively. But they both produce cavitation fields due to the negative pressure. And then you can demonstrate that the energy that you can actually use for treating your patients with a focused shockwave device is at a distance to the applicator, whereas for radial shockwave, the energy is close to the applicator. So radial is good for superficial indications. Focus is good for deep indications. We come back to that in a few minutes. But let's first have a look how such a shockwave actually develops. The technology we are using for visualizing them is called shadow imaging. So you shoot into water, and with a high-speed camera you can actually take these pictures, and you see how the wave is actually emitted from the applicator here, and then you see positive and negative pressure, black and white. And then you see cavitation bubbles here, and you see the cavitation field approximately 2.5 centimeters above this applicator that has a diameter of 15 millimeter. Let's have a look at a focused shockwave. That's actually the same. You see the wave coming here, positive, negative. This is focused to a certain spot, which is actually here. This is the focused spot. You see the cavitation field developing, and you see that the cavitation field is pretty much around the focus spot. So that is the same what I just showed you before. So in this publication, we did not only put together 100 randomized controlled trials about focused and radial shockwave therapy with respect to their efficacy and safety. If you would like to know more about this, you can find all the details there. But we also demonstrated how focused shockwaves are generated, how radial shockwaves are generated. This is the electrohydraulic principle. This is how the soft wave device actually works. This is the electromagnetic principle. This is how the stored steel-lit focused part works, like a loudspeaker, and the wave goes through an acoustic lens is focused on a single spot. And this is how the piezoelectric device is working, which I just showed you before. You have here many, many piezo crystals. If you put a current on them, they change their shape. If that happens underwater, you get little waves and they come all together at one single spot. With radial, it's completely different. This is pretty much an air gun. With the key difference, the projectile does not leave the guiding tube, but strikes a metal applicator, causes a stress wave in the metal applicator, and this is then transmitted as a radial shockwave into the tissue. Very short about the key molecular mechanism of action. Also, to make here a very, very long story short, we have found the mechanism 22 years ago. It's pretty much the same what capsaicin is doing at the surface of the skin. It overstimulates the C fibers in order to make them quiet. You can see that here a little bit more detail. This is a C fiber. This has a free nerve ending here. If this free nerve ending is activated by ischemia, by hypoxia, by mechanical irritation, then it fires to the central nervous system, causes pain. But in addition to that, it has axon collaterals, and these axon collaterals are pretty close to the free nerve ending itself, and they emit substance P if the C nerve fiber is activated. Substance P activate mast cells. Mast cells release histamine that can activate the free nerve sending. Substance P can let capillaries put more liquid into the interstitial space. That can also activate free nerve endings by swellings if there is no space in the tissue. For example, at the places where the tendons meet the bone or at the periosteum. So the C nerve fiber fires a little bit more, patients feel a little bit more pain, and here in the periphery you get a vicious circle which is called neurogenic inflammation. And the mechanism of action of capsaicin at the skin surface and of shockwave deep in the tissue is to overstimulate these C fibers to such an extent that they cannot emit substance P anymore. This blocks here the neurogenic inflammation in the periphery, and this is why shockwave is so effective in treating tendinopathies and myofascial pain syndrome. But it must hurt, as you can actually see here to some extent, because if you do not overstimulate the C fibers effectively, you will not have the effect you would like to see. But please keep in mind, this is only one of many, many, many mechanisms. There are more than 100 others described in the literature, because shockwave also has a rehabilitation effect on the tissue. If you'd like more about this, in this publication you can find all of these different effects. Let's come back to the question, where do I have my energy? These are minimum intensity projections of the movies I just showed you, and I put them here together, and then you can actually see that what you cannot reach with radial shockwaves anymore, you can reach with focused shockwaves. But if you would like to treat superficial indications with a focused shockwave device, you have to put a spacer between the applicator and the patient, otherwise you would not hit the superficial application, the superficial indication, because the energy would go too deep. And let's have a short look at anatomy. Most of the indications you're actually treating are superficial indications and can perfectly be reached with radial extracorporeal shockwaves, and this is the reason why we are actually doing this. So if all this is correct, then it should be that you get the same outcome with radial shockwave therapy and with focused shockwave therapy on superficial indications. And we can actually demonstrate this by comparing the results of these two FDA approval studies. This was the one for the Swiss Dollarklast on plantar fasciopathy, and the same group ran another study for the approval of the stored stoolid focused part in the United States, also for plantar fasciopathy, and they just copied and pasted the protocol, and therefore the baseline characteristics of the patients were actually the same in all four groups that were investigated: shockwave radial, sham radial shockwave, focused shockwave, sham focused shockwave. And if you look at the results, then you can actually see here the closed bars represent the results of the Dollarklast radial, and the dark gray bars those of the stored stoolid focused. Whereas the same at baseline and at 3 months, there was essentially no any difference in outcome. Shockwave has a profound placebo effect, as you can see here. Open gray bars is Dollarklast sham and open bars is stoolid sham. And you have to be better than the placebo effect, otherwise you may just treat your patients with the placebo effect. You can see that in the median values, the difference what was achieved with shockwave and with placebo was much more pronounced than here, which is due to the fact that here you have a few outliers, non-responders that do not affect the median values, but the mean values. To make here another very, very long story short, for superficial indications, radial is as good as focused. So another question is, how much energy do I actually have to apply? Or I turn it a different way, can I compensate a shockwave device that emits only weak shockwaves by just treating a little longer? And the answer is no. This is already known for focused shockwaves since 20 years, and for radial shockwaves it was just demonstrated again a few years ago on this beautiful study on the treatment of knee osteoarthritis. So if you would like to know what actually happens if you treat knee osteoarthritis with a device that does not produce shockwaves with enough energy of every single shot and just treat a little longer, then this is the study you should read, where you can actually find that this is not effective at all. Why is this important? Because in this study it was demonstrated that different radial shockwave devices may have profound differences in their energy signature. And I just show you here the outcome. This is the energy density, the positive part, and these are the results for the dollar class. You see here the energy density as a function of frequency and then color-coded what you get if you run the device with 1 bar, 2 bar, 3 bar and 4 bar. And except of this little drop here, you see that the energy density you get is independent of the frequency at which you apply the radial shockwaves. This is the same for a Storz radial device, and you see a profound difference. The energy drops with increasing frequency of the shockwaves. So if you use this device to treat patients at a frequency of 20 Hz and you put it at 4 bar, then the shockwaves have pretty much the same energy than those created with the dollar class at 1 bar. And 5 bar with the Storz device has no advantage over 4 bar with the dollar class. It's actually the other way around. So please keep this in mind when you talk about radial shockwave therapy. There are fundamental differences in the energy signature of the different devices. Why is the dollar class so different from all the others? Because AMS has this specific patent on the energy management. And as a result, the waves generated with the dollar class differ from the radial shockwaves generated with all other radial devices.